This video covers the bipyramids and trapezohedra, which are the duals of the uniform prisms and antiprisms, focusing on the non-convex varieties. I'll be exploring these objects from the simple, through the more complicated, to the bizarre and spectacular. The dual of a prism is a bipyramid. For a convex prism, this is a simple convex bipyramid, which I've covered in an earlier video. But for a non-convex prism, it's a bit more complicated, as the bipyramid will have intersecting faces. These three are among the simplest. If I highlight one face in red and the opposite face in yellow, it helps to understand the structure. Each face is partly hidden within the centre. If the size gets larger, keeping a low density, the shapes get longer. But if the density increases too, we get a complicated structure, like this 57 over 14 gonal bipyramid. Each face is almost entirely hidden within the structure, only narrow strips being exposed to view. If the density is very high, we get something like this 57 over 28 gonal bipyramid, with short, exceptionally wide faces spanning the entire figure. The dual of an antiprism is a trapezohedron. As with bipyramids, convex trapezohedra are fairly simple, like these shapes. But non-convex trapezohedra are more complex, especially when the density is high. Trapezohedra have kite-shaped faces that become taller with the number of sides and broader with the density. A combination of high number of sides and high density results in some magnificent shapes. Furthermore, antiprisms can be crossed, in which case the dual is a crossed trapezohedron. These have concave, dart-shaped faces. To understand how they're put together, I'll assemble this 10 over 3 gonal trapezohedron, one face at a time. The faces are kite shapes, 10 of which surround a vertex. They encircle the vertex 3 times, each face intersecting 4 other faces. This forms an open bowl shape. This joins with the second bowl, completing the trapezohedron. Let's look at a sequence of trapezohedra with a large number of sides as the density increases. The antiprism is on the left, the dual trapezohedron on the right, and the two together in dual position in the centre. The trapezohedron face shape is in green at the top right. 43 over 1 is the convex antiprism, and the trapezohedron is too tall to fit on the screen. The face is so thin it can hardly be seen. As the density increases, the trapezohedron shortens and develops a band across the centre. The face shape also shortens. The central band can now be seen to have a crisscrossing structure, not dissimilar to the antiprism, and the points at the top and bottom are becoming shallower. When the density reaches 21, very nearly half of 43, the points disappear and the trapezohedron looks remarkably like its dual antiprism. So it seems the 43 over 21 gonal antiprism is almost self-dual. But an antiprism is made of triangles and a trapezohedron made of quadrilaterals. How is it that they look even remotely similar? Well, if you look at the face shape, you can see that one vertex has an angle close to 180 degrees, so the face is very close to a triangle. Now, if we strip away faces of the antiprism, leaving just 4 adjacent faces, we see that they are arranged almost like a tetrahedron. And a tetrahedron is self-dual, so the dual trapezohedron must also contain an almost tetrahedron. Stripping down the trapezohedron in similar fashion, we can see that this is indeed the case. And the dual pair shows the almost tetrahedra in mutually dual position. Restoring all faces and resuming our journey through the densities, as the density edges up to 22, just over half of 43, we now have a crossed antiprism and crossed trapezohedron, but they still look remarkably similar. The face shape has changed from a convex kite to a concave dart, but still close to a triangle. As the density goes up further, the top and bottom of the trapezohedron become concave, until at 28, the maximum possible density, the trapezohedron is very long and spiky. As always, thank you for watching. Please give a like if you found this interesting, and see you in the next video.